One of my captors felt no emotion.
Okay, so showcase the map. Very budget. I might die to him. Yeah, exactly. I just don't know how to avoid it yet. Let's try now. That's the DPS showcase. The build gets around 11 million DPS somehow, somewhat. And Burgess is less than 4 divines. I will just link the path of building under my video. And I showcase you. Let's break down the build. Start with the items, the gear. We're using the Rallakesh Impatience. It's basically the essential part of our build. Because it gives us a frenzy charge, power charges, and endurance charges non stop. Like non conditional ones. Which cannot be taken away from us, and that's great. We should allow us to get some decent damage, DPS. The other essential part of the build is White Wind, because it's cheap. It costs around one chaos only. That depends on roles. Might be like 20 chaos, but it's still cheap. Next thing is rings, timings. They are more expensive ones. They cost around 20 chaos each. They give us plenty of increased elemental damage and most importantly elemental resistance. Plus they give us a chance to freeze, shock and ignite, which works well with Yoke of Suffering. So it gives us another 5% increased damage for each element we inflict, which is just fantastic. It also gives us a lot of elemental resistance. We don't need to use Mage Blood, but later on we should use it. Or Headhunter, just swap the belt. This amulet costs around, let me check. Thank. Just a second. 4 chaos. 3 chaos, 4 chaos. It's cheap. The only expensive part of this is Anoint. It cost me 3 gold oils, which go 1 divine each right now. But it's not essential. We just got this because we are using the sniper mark right here. Where I put it. Right here on, and mark on hit. Plus we got elemental curse from gloves, which is not essential, but it's good. It gives us around 10% increased damage. And the gloves, the ones I bought for 70 chaos, they are cheap. The only essential part on them is maximum frenzy charges. You can also use the rare gloves and pretty much every gloves with frenzy charge. It don't really matter. The belt. We can use the either belt of the saver or the magnet. Both are good. The magnet gives us more strength and can sculpt better, but this one is also good. Like, both are decent. The other part, like, maybe not essential, but it's good. It's a fractal torch. It's cheap mask. I got this one with maximum power charge. It's still cheap, around 50 chaos. And it gives us a lot of global critical multiplier and some damage for dexterity, but it's not really important. It gives us some flat life from intelligence, but the most important part is it gives us a 40% crit multi, and it's good helmet to have on. And other stuff, the like more pricey stuff, is a lore wave. It costs. I bought this one for 6 divines, but it's just white sockets, and you can just buy one with right colors for 2 divines, so it's 2 divines most. I just bought white because it's more handy. And it gives us a lot of quality of life, like maximum resistance set on 78, so we can run a lot of maps with minus elemental resistance and don't basically care about it, which is just fantastic, and you own it. We can also use other stuff on them, like even tabula rasa up to, let's say, tier 14, which we could still run them on tabula rasa. It's not that much of a big deal. And let's go back to our tree. It looks like this. We start from here, moving there. Basically, you just see yourself. You know what to do. The most important part is Letter Pride. It gives us a lot of strength. We just require it. It's just basically for capping strength. We go this way just to get some suppression plus handy movement speed. And this one for also suppression, and we are basically capped with those nodes and white wind if it got 40% suppress. Then we just fill the those nodes basically for daggers, more criticals, and also this one critical one. And we go for charisma and puts whatever jewels in this. Like this, those for like this one goes for 20 chaos maybe. They give us plenty of DPS, like 5% in POB, but they can be swapped for some better. We need to fill the franchise nodes, they are important. Fill life nodes. We don't need to go for cluster jewels because we are on budget. We just get the reduced projectile speed from 3. It's very efficient. And let us overlap. Point blank is important because it's basically 50% more damage. Oh, I show you the anoint. If you don't want to buy the gloves with curse with elemental weakness on hit, you can just go with the different anoint than the Whisper of Doom and save 3 divines on going for where it is cold damage. This one is really good. Yeah, you just save 2 divines because it's 1 divine instead of 3 divine, and we are using pretty much. On this showcase, I did not use any flask, but you can just fill the diamond flask, quicksilver flask, silver flask, and we don't even need to use the ruby flask. There's lots of possibilities, and that's just basically lowest budget, maybe not lowest budget, but reasonably low budget I could think of for now. That's how the build is working. No clusters. No flask, no mage blood, just 5, from 2 to 6 divines budget on this build, and just plays very well. And it's also good League start because those stuff are cheap on League, maybe apart from Lore Wave and Relaka Sympathies, but Relaka Sympathies maybe go for, I don't know, two divines they, like first day on League, so they are still quite cheap on League start. So it's not expensive and you can try it out. And I link the POB in the description. Thank you for watching.